Right. Now we are going to discuss average speed. So just now we computed the speed and velocity. Right, Nana? What is speed? Speed is equal to distance by time. What is velocity? Velocity is equal to displacement by time. Speed is dash quantity. We know very well distance is a scalar quantity. So speed is also a scalar quantity, no direction. Displacement is a vector quantity. So velocity is also a vector quantity. Next, we know already uniform speed, non-uniform speed. Next one, average speed, instantaneous speed, so here also uniform velocity, non-uniform velocity, average velocity, instantaneous velocity. Let's see here. Actually, in lower classes we studied uniform speed and non-uniform speed. But in higher classes, only two types of speeds are there. One is average speed, another one is instantaneous speed. So when average speed is useful means when the time interval is large. The time interval is large. Suppose Khamman to Hyderabad, the distance is 200 kilometers. The car covered 200 kilometers in 4 hours. See, the time interval is 4 hours. So if time interval is large, that time the speed is average speed. Next, instantaneous speed. Instantaneous speed means if time interval is very very small. That means time should be very small. That is instantaneous speed. So only two types of speed is there. Okay, now here also simply average speed means if time interval is large. If large time interval, that is represented by delta t mathematically. Instantaneous velocity means time interval should be very very small. That is instantaneous velocity. Today we are going to discuss only average speed and average velocity. Right. Already know what is average speed. Average speed is equal to total distance by total time taken. Okay. Average velocity. Average velocity is equal to total displacement by total time taken. So already you know theory. Just now in this session we are concentrating on the numericals on average speed. Next, we know very well what is the unit of speed, standard unit meter per second. Suppose if kilometer per hour is there, convert kilometer per hour into meter per second, that is 5 by 18 meter per second. If meter per second is given, convert into kilometer per means that is 18 by 5 kilometer per hour. Okay, Nana? Right, now we are going to discuss numericals. Numericals on average speed. So that is our class, today's class. Right, see the board, Nana? Watch the video carefully. Right. First question. A boy walks 3 meters west. Then 2 meters east, find his average speed and average velocity. This is a question. So a ball walks 3 meters in 2 seconds and 2 meters in 3 seconds. Then calculate average speed and average velocity. So see here now, you know very well. First you draw directions north, east, west. So see here, initially a boy walks 3 meters west. 3 meters west. So this is the origin. So this is 3 meters. From there he moves 2 meters east. From there, 2 meters east. Okay, now, average speed means, we know very well, total time taken. Okay, now, average velocity, total displacement by total time taken. Then see here, first calculate average speed. So average speed, total distance means from here to here, how much distance? 3 meters. Suppose this point is A, this point is B, and this point is C. So A to B, 3 meters, and B to C, 2 meters. So 3 meters plus 2 meters, this is a total distance. Then total time taken is 3 meters in 2 seconds, 2 meters in 3 seconds. That is 3 seconds plus 2 seconds. That is 5 meters by 5 seconds. The answer is 1 meter per second. Next one, average velocity. See here, average velocity. Average velocity means total displacement. Displacement means, we know very well. How you can calculate displacement? Displacement means final position minus initial position by total time. So what is the initial position? Initial position is A. What is the final position here? C. Here. A is the initial position. B is the final position. So this is displacement. What is, how much this length? This length is 1 meter. So here displacement means final position. Final position minus initial position. Means this is the initial position, this is the final position. The difference of this is displacement, that is 1 meter by total time. See, a time should be added because time is a scalar quantity. So 3 seconds plus 2 seconds, 3 seconds plus 2 seconds, that is 1 meter by 5 seconds. So 1 by 5, that is 0.2 meter per second. So average speed is 1 meter per second. Average velocity is 0.2 meter per second. Next here, another second question. A man goes A to B at V1 speed and returns B to A at V2 speed. Find average speed and average velocity. This is a question. Let's see here. A man goes A to B. See here, this is A, this is B. A to B. Suppose A to B distance is D. D at the speed of V1. So A to B speed V1 and returns B to A. So B to A distance is D and returns B to A with speed V2. Then calculate average speed and average velocity. See here, A to B, B to A. This is the initial point and B to A means this is the final point. Here only initial, here only final. Then what is the displacement? Displacement, net displacement. So net displacement is equal to 0. If net displacement is equal to 0, If displacement is 0, 0 by something is equal to 0. So average velocity is equal to 0. So remember, my dear students, while doing the problems of average velocity, if the where the body is started, if initial and final points are same, then net displacement is equal to 0. So directly write the answer. In that case, average velocity becomes 0. Now calculate average speed. See here, average speed. Average speed is equal to total distance by total time taken. Total distance means A to B, how much distance? A to B distance is D, B to A distance is D. So A to B distance is D plus B to A distance is D by total time. Total time means T1 plus T2. Suppose the time is from A to B is T1, from B to A is T2. But in this question, there is no involvement of time. It means time is not mentioned. So which one is missing here? Time is missing. In this question, time is missing. So first, read the question and find which term is missing. Only here, three terms are required. What are the three terms, madam? One is speed, another one is distance, and another one is time. So speed equal distance by time. First to find which one is missing. Here time is missing. So express the subject the missing one. So time. So subject the time. So time is equal to distance by speed. Distance by speed. Simple. So find here in the place of time, time is equal to distance by speed. If you don't know time, no problem. Simply express time in terms of distance and speed. So if T1 is equal to how much distance? D. How much speed? V1. Here T2 equal to how much distance? D. How much speed? V2. So in the place of T1 and T2, write D1 by V1, D2 by V2. So here in the place of T1, D1 by V1 plus D2 by V2. So this is equal to 2D by, take D common, so 1 by V1 plus 1 by V2. So DD gets cancelled. So 2 by, see here V1, V2 LCM, V1, V2 LCM. Here V1 is there, so V2. Plus here V2 is there. So simply average speed equal to, if V1, V2 goes upside, V1, V2 by V1 plus V2. So this is average speed. Okay, Anna? Suppose in the same problem, a man goes A to B at a speed of 40 km per hour and returns B to A at a speed of 60 km per hour. See here, A to B at 40 km per hour speed, B to A at 60 km per hour speed. Then calculate average speed and average velocity. We know very well A to B and B to A. So initial is A, final is also A. So net displacement equal to 0. So average velocity becomes 0. Then see here, calculate average speed. Same procedure. Here time is not mentioned. See here in this problem, only A to B means same B to A also same distance and speed is given. There is no time. So simply express time and do all these. So this is the final formula. So 2 into, what is the speed here? 40. What is the speed here? V2? 60. By 40 plus 60. So this is equal to 2 into 40 plus 60 by 100. 0, 0, 0, 0 gets cancelled. 2, 4, 8, 8, 6, 48. So the answer is 48 km per hour. So average speed in this case is 48 km per hour. But some students, they are doing average speed means, average speed is equal to, they are doing like this, 40 plus 60 by 2, that is 100 by 2, that is 50 km per hour. This is wrong answer. Because average speed is not equal to, already I explained to you so many times, average speed is not equal to average of the speeds. So average speed is not equal to average of the speeds. Average speed is equal to total distance by total time. So do like this. Okay, now then come to one more problem. So do another. Next third problem. See here. Let's see a third problem. A man covers three equal distances. A man covers three equal distances at V1, V2, and V3 speeds. Okay, then find average speed. So this is a question. Find average speed. See, there are three equal distances. Suppose from here to here distance is d, here to here distance is d, here also distance d. So equal distances, but speeds are different. So v1, v2, v3. So by seeing this problem, which one is missing? First of all, because average speed is equal to total distance by total time taken. So distance is there, speed is there. Which one is missing? Time is missing. So first write that one. Time is missing. So time is equal to distance by speed. Then calculate here. In this place time is equal to distance. Distance is d, speed is v1. Here time is equal to distance d, speed is v2. Here distance d, speed is v3. Then calculate average speed. So now see, here average speed is equal to total distance. Total distance means d plus d by total time taken. Total time taken. Here time is d by v1 plus d by v2 plus d by v3. This is equal to 3d by d common. That is 1 by V1 plus 1 by V2 plus 1 by V3. So DD gets cancelled. Then this is equal to, here LCM is V1, V2, V3. See here V1, V2, V3. Okay, now. Then here V1 is there. Which one is not there? V2, V3. So write V2, V3. Plus here V2 is there. So V1, V3. Here V3 is there. V1, V2. So this is equal to 3V1, V2, V3 by, simply I will write in the ascending order, V1, V2, V2, V3 and V3, V1. So this is average speed form. Okay, now the last problem today's, last problem. A man goes a man covers a distance with V1 speed. With V1 speed and V2 speed with two equal time intervals. Then find average speed. This is a question. See here. A man covers a distance. Otherwise, remove this one if any. A man moves with v1 speed and v2 speed with two equal time intervals. That means here, Nana. He moves with speed v1 and v2 with two equal time intervals. That means he moves v1 speed with time interval t and v2 speed also with time interval t. The time intervals are same. Then calculate average speed. So you see, speed is there, time is there. Which one is missing? Here, distance is missing. Then we know very well, speed is equal to distance by time. Which one is missing here? Distance. So subject that one, distance is equal to speed into time. So here distance is equal to d1 is equal to speed. Here speed how much? v1 time t. Here distance d2, speed how much? v2 time t. Then we know very well. Then write average speed. Total distance. Total distance means distance d1 distance plus d2 by total term d1 plus d2. Because here distance is not given, so express distance in terms of speed and time. In the place of d1, we can write v1t. In the place of v2, we can write v2t by time intervals t plus t. So if you take common t here, v1 plus v2 by t plus t, 2t. Tt gets cancelled, this is equal to v1 plus v2 by 2. So this is average speed. So average speed is equal to v1 plus v2 by 2. I hope the concept of average speed is very much clear to you and numericals also very clear to you. But thank you.